for Addis and for Ethiopia, not only in business and diplomatic sectors, which is probably well known and very famous, but leisure also. I believe with a bit more international experience that the leisure segment is a great opportunity for Addis and for the country. I think Ethiopia as a brand, I think Ethiopia as a brand, it's getting stronger outside Ethiopia. A lot of tour operators, a lot of travel agencies from abroad, they are approaching to us saying, you know, the amount of travelers with a leisure interest, traditional interest, what is happening in Ethiopia, with the culture, with the people here. So it's growing. So for us, it's getting stronger, and definitely it's an opportunity for our hotel for the future and for the present. Obviously, the new airport terminal will help us and will provide, as you probably know, around 22 million passengers every year. So we'll contribute to the growth of the business in Ethiopia, and obviously if the business grows, our hotel will be definitely much more successful. So talking about this new airport, talking about the leisure segment, talking about the business, talking about 2019 Ethiopia and Addis, so what are we expecting? That would be the main question, yeah, $1 million questions. What are we expecting for us? Not only as a Best Western Plus, as a hoteliers, and as a in our investor and our main owner, but what is the future and the present for Addis? But of course, we have some figures from the STR source, global STR, that they say that the demand in 2019 has grown for 12.6, but the supplier, actually, the room inventory of the city has grown 4.3. So that's obviously is telling us that there is an opportunity to open new hotels and to increase the supply in order to cope with the demand. So myself, from a very humble, and very new opinion, I see, and after discussing with many people who's been living here for a while and knowing the market, I definitely see big projections for the market, and we are expecting that the market within the next few years will develop and will grow the hospitality market and hotel here in Ethiopia and Addis. So after this very brief market analysis and projections, what do we offer? What is Best Western Plus Hotel offering to the market, to the people? So actually, briefly, we experience here in Ethiopia. So our goal is for everybody in Ethiopia and also for international business world to stay with us, to enjoy with us the Best Western Plus Addis for business and also for leisure. We want our visitors to enjoy the authentic hospitality provided by our team. And we believe that at that level, we can only guarantee and consistently service by a global hotel chain. Like as we are, we have more than 4,500 hotels all around the world. In around 100 countries. So with the support of the experience of Best Western Plus and the support of our head office as well, we are actually achieving, and that's our commitment. So talking about the travelers, well, who comes here? What are the expectations? Or the people who actually consume hotel services, yes, as such. So in the past, the main purpose of the travelers were basically to reach to the desired destination, safe, quick, and have the basic accommodation standards. That was in the past. In today's world, all those have been changed, and the whole experience of the journey of the traveler it gained much more importance. In the recent years, the traveler habits and expectations have changed. The traveler, hundreds of thousands of people that we receive every year in our hotel, they're actually expecting the same everywhere. So there is no excuses anymore to say, I'm gonna book a hotel in New York, or in Madrid, or in Roma, or in London, or in Addis. They don't have any different. For them, they have exactly the same expectations. And this is actually our commitment and our responsibility as a Best Western Plus, my responsibility, all our team responsibility, to deliver actually those expectations here in Addis. Those expectations are basically not, as I said before, just go in and out, sleep, and bye-bye, or adios. Actually, they're expecting, a comfort that they have at home, but away. And this all without, paying a ridiculous amount of money. And this is actually where we're standing, what is our vision in Best Western Plus Addis. We want to deliver this amazing food experience, amazing service experience, amazing accommodation experience, a proper shower, to be connected, very important, 24/7, to be reachable 24/7 as well, but with a good value, with not paying a huge amount of money. So this is a bit our target. So you probably will be asking, okay, fair enough, but how are you gonna do this? it's not an easy thing. This is a hotel where there is a lot of rational processes, but there is a lot of emotional processes as well, a lot of emotions in a hotel. We are living and we are managing a business which is, we are not producing nothing, we are producing experiences, we are producing emotions. And this is very important for us to understand this. We have around, depending the month, but an average of 220 employees in our hotel. For those that don't know a bit the hotel business, but we divide those 220 in different divisions. We have food divisions, food and drink division, we have accommodation, we have human resources, finance, sales, purchasing, etc. We have different divisions. Those divisions, each one has different responsibilities and different tasks, but regardless the different tasks of each one, we have one common goal here and one common vision, which is our guests. For us, the guest is the reason to be here. For us, the guest is our mission. So ensure that the guests, when they leave our house, when they leave the Best Western Plus, they're happy. And this is what we are working with the team every single day. We have a dedicated guest experience or guest relation management department, which are daily monitoring every single guest experience, not only while they are here, but we have a whole process of pre-arrival, monitoring the arrival, the experience they have while they are in our hotel, the Best Western, departure and post-departure. We also call our guests, inform them, have you been safe home, How was your stay? So we asked as much feedback as possible. We have also a very much strong, dedicated food and beverage department with experts with an international experience, which they are daily working extremely hard to ensure that we meet the guest expectations. Food is also considering that we have travelers from all around the world, and I think for my little experience here in your country, you probably understand very much what I'm trying to say, that each country has a very much strong food culture, as you have it as well. So our team is trying to also exceed and fulfill all our travelers from all around the world, ensure that they have a good food, a good drink, and a safe, especially a very much safe food here in our hotel. So, talking about the team, my Best Western Plus and myself, as well as a leader of this hotel, is for me, the team is our main asset, okay? I strongly believe that you have a happy team, you have a happy guest. So in that regards, we are spending together with our human resources department, with our training department, we're spending a lot of time to identify growth and core employees, to identify our talent, our young talent, and work on developing them. Most of the times when we try to recruit people, we recruit not much knowledge, but we recruit attitudes, and that help us to actually train them. We do trainings in-house, we do trainings online, digital platform, we do webinars, we do trainings, corporate trainings. So that's actually our idea, to develop the young talent of Ethiopia. That I strongly believe will be the future for the hospitality and hospitality industry here in Addis and in the whole country. But Best Western Plus is not only delivering and meeting the travelers' expectations, the people who come from abroad. Our experience during this year is that we have actually become a very popular hotel in Bole. People come here to enjoy, to meet, even though they are not in our hotel. I mean, the people from Addis, they come to enjoy, to meet, to relax. We do a lot of celebrations, to eat, to drink. And basically, we starting becoming a place where people come to socialize and to enjoy after a long working days and relax. We became, as I can see a bit, after only 1 year. As I said, 1 year is nothing for a hotel, absolutely nothing. So after 1 year, we already see that, you know, we became a bit of an entertainment center where people, where we can offer a multi experience in our hotel. As the Sufkat has already explained you, we have our spa, for example, that people and fitness center that people can come and take care of their body and their souls a bit with nice treatments, sauna, hammams, etc. We have a very much also a multi food and beverage experience, restaurants with different projects. We have live music in our lobby bar every Saturday. We have broadcasting a lot of sport events, especially football, that I have observed. You have the same taste that we do in Spain. You love football here, so we do a lot of broadcasting. Actually, for the final of the Champions League, we are going to do it upstairs in our 10th floor as well. And basically, we give this a bit of for the Addis people. We give this entertainment center, a place that you can always come and you can enjoy with friends and with family. So just to a bit summarize and to close a bit my explanation and to go through your questions. Basically, we just plant a little seed to grow a tree. We are watering this tree every single day with a lot of passion, because in the hotel business, if you don't have heart and if you don't have passion, you will never succeed. So the whole team, we watering this tree every single day, every single hour with a lot of passion. And we are very excited to see how our Best Western Plus tree will grow very strong, solid, healthy for the future of Addis and Ethiopia in general, for the tourist industry. So that's all from my side. Thank you very much. If you have any question. It's a big welcoming from my team and from many people, or most of the people I have met, from suppliers, from clients. So that this welcoming thing, it's something that we really need to explode and to make it potentially in our hotel. That's from the from the personality and people from different countries. Obviously, we have here some challenges that in much more developed cities we don't have in terms of supply. Okay, we are looking for supply goods. It's something that it takes longer because, as you very well know, that some of the suppliers, in order to run a hotel, we can find them locally. But some of them we need to find them from abroad. We need to import them. So this gap of timing from that you buy it until you receive it is long. But this is a challenge that every challenge has a solution. So what we need to work together with the team in Addis is to plan much more in advance. So if we plan in advance, if we have a good purchasing planning in that regards, we will avoid and we will minimize most of those supply issues. That's basically the difference what I can observe at the beginning, at the moment. As I said before, our business is all about emotions. When we are talking about our team, at the end is the same structure. You have a 200, 300 employees that you need to take care of them. And what I can see already is that regardless where you are in the world, if you give, you receive. So if we give a lot to our staff, if we give a lot to our guests, if we want to give a lot to our clients, they will end up feeling, regardless where you are in Barcelona or in any other city or Addis, this is a common thing in our business. To the second question was, about challenges. Our contribution from the hotel, I already have, I think, mentioned it during my presentation. Everything which is an international service to Addis, which you have had for so many years, one or two only international hotels. The contribution not only from Best Western Plus, for most of the international hotels that we've recently, for the last few years, we open our doors here. That would be one. And that goes in line with developing people as well. So if we developed the talent, as I say, we developed the young Ethiopians that they want to dedicate their life and their passion to a hotel business. So we are giving all this developing to them, which actually will be, as I said a few times, the future of Ethiopia hospitality industry. We give jobs, 220 jobs. I think it's not bad. With their careers, we give careers, and we give at the end of the day know-how in a very specific industry. So those would be the main contributors to the market. Challenges. Well, every hotel, which I opened three hotels in my career in three different countries, open a hotel, just open a hotel is a challenge, it's a huge challenge, okay? Because a hotel is like, it's a very complex business where we touch everything. We touch food, we touch accommodation, we touch finance, we touch human resources. It's like a mini city. And we are influenced by many factors. If the cotton price goes up, it hits us because we buy linen. If the petrol goes up or the fuel, it hits us. If the electricity goes up, if the food goes up, deflection goes up, anything goes up or down, it hits us. So opening a hotel is a main challenge. What I would say, as I said, I'm just 2 months here, but what I experience or what I have seen and I have been told by our owners and by the team, the first year is all about fine-tuning. You have a bebé that you just open the doors, and you start receiving hundreds of people every single day with their expectations. So first year has been fine-tuning our technical equipment in the hotel, from air conditions, Wi-Fis, etc. It takes a bit of time to start working properly. One of our challenges / opportunities also has been, and successes altogether has been to build a solid team. So we have a good executive team that they are supporting every day the rest of their teams. So when you, as I said before, you start a hotel, you bring 220 people. They are all different. They all have different expectations. So that takes a bit of time until, you know, you start feeling comfortable, you start feeling that you are, you start knowing your hotel, you know your product, you know your guests, you know your colleagues. So this is also a challenge, not obviously only in Addis, for any opening hotel. And then the last challenge, again, I don't like the word challenge, I like the word of opportunity, but the challenge / opportunity would be to know our guest expectations. When you just open a hotel, you open with a, you know, with a set. It's like when you go and buy a car, yeah? You buy a car, they give it to you, but after 2 days, you put the mobile. After 3 days, you put the sticker. After 4 days, you put the perfume. So you fine-tune your car to you, yeah? You like to put your things or your house. You buy an empty house and you start, you know, building. And after 2 or 3 years, you feel like, I feel like homey, yeah? So hotel is exactly the same. We opened a hotel a year ago, and now after 1 year, we see our guest expectations, what they like more for breakfast, what they like more for room service, what they like more for the rooms, how fast they like the check-in, the shuttle service we have to the airport. So we start knowing the trends and the habits and the expectations from our clients. And now after 1 year and a lot of guest feedback we have received from different sources. So this actually, has been the challenge until now, that we already understand them, they understand us as well. So we managed to overachieve this and actually deliver what we have committed since day one. There was any other question?
Regarding the social responsibility. In the talk, ብለን ብቻ አለ ሶሻል ሪስፖንሲቢሊቲ ላይ የምንሳተፈው ሆቴላችን ሚኒስተር ይባ እንደገለጹት ከ4500 በላይ ሆቴሎች አሉ። ከ100 በላይ ሀገራት ውስጥ የሚገኝ ነው፣ ቤስት ዌስተርን ብራንድ ማለት ነው። እና ጥሩ ከቨሬጅ አለው፣ ብዙ ሰው ያውቀዋል። ግን የሀገር ውስጥ ጉዳይ ነው። ሀገር ውስጥ ደግሞ ኢትዮጵያዊ ነው። ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ የሚገኝ ስለሆነ ኢትዮጵያውያን መጠቀም አለባቸው። የሀገሩ ሰው ሀገሩ መጠቀም አለበት። እና ያንን እንዲያደርግ ደግሞ እኛም የተለያዩ ማስታወቂያዎችን እንሰራለን። ምናልባት ፍላየር ደርሷችሁ ከሆነ ቢዝነስ ላንች አለን፣ ሱፐር ቢዝነስ ላንች አለን። ሰው መቶ ቤቱን እንዲያየው፣ ቤስ ዌስተር እንዲያውቀው እራት አለን። ኢንተርናሽናል ቤት ዲነር አለን። የተለያዩ ሀገር ዜጎችን ደግሞ ማስተናገድ እንድንችል የጣሊያን ምግቦች፣ የቱርኮችን፣ ኢንዲያ ኢንተርናሽናል የሆኑ ክፍሎችን ሰርቭ እናደርጋለን። እራት ላይ በየሳምንቱ ሙዚቃ አለን። ያ ምንድን ነው? ሰው እንዲያቀርቡ ደፈር ገብቶ ቤስት ዌስተርንን እንዲያውቀው ነው። ሶሻል ሪስፖንሲቢሊቲ እናደርጋለን። ከምን እንጀምራለን? በዶኔሽን ሰጥተናል። ከአዲስ አበባ ከመስቀል ከመስቀል ጋር የሆነ ተባበር እዚሁ ራሳቸው መጥተው ሰራተኞቻችንን አደራጅተን ዶኔት አድርገናል። ያው ጥሩ የሆነ ነገር ነው፣ ደስ የሚል ነው። ሌላ ደግሞ እነዚህ ወላጅ አልባ ህጻናቶችን የተቸገሩ ሰዎችን ከመንገድ ላይ የሚነሱ ወንድሞቻችንን የሚረዱ ድርጅቶች አሉ። ለእነሱም ደግሞ አልባሳትን፣ ጫማዎችን፣ እንደገና ደግሞ የትምህርት መሳሪያዎችን፣ ምግቦችን፣ የታሸጉ ምግቦችን አቅርበናል። የተወሰኑ ሰርተፊኬቶችም አግኝተናል። ግን ያን ያህል እኛ ይሄኛውን ዶኔሽን ለማስታወቂያ አልተጠቀምንበት እንጂ እያደረግን ነው። በቀጣይነት ደግሞ ወደ ችግኝ ተከላ ልንሄድ አስበናል። እንደምታውቁት አሁን ዓለም እየተጨነቀች እየተጠበበች ያለበት ሁኔታ ነው። የአየር ለውጥ የምታዩት ነው። እኛም ጋር ዝናብ ሆኗል በግንቦት ፀሐይ ነበር ድሮ እና እዛ ያንንም ደግሞ ኮንሲደር በማድረግ በማሰብ በቅርቡ የችግኝ ተከላ ይኖረናል። በጀትም አለ ለሶሻል ሪስፖንሲቢሊቲ ውሃ በበጀት ቱ ዶኔት ማለት ነው እና ቱ ዶኔት ቲንክስ አመሰግናለሁ።
ንስቱዲስ
አሁን ከሶሻል ሪስፖንሲቢሊቲ አንጻር እንዳልኩ ወደ ችግኝ ተከላዎች ይሄዳል። በዋነኝነትም በቀጣይኛ መስራት የምንፈልገው እንግዶቻችንን በዋነኝነት ማስደሰት ነው የምንፈልገው። ከዛ ደግሞ ሰራተኞቻችን ነው ዊ ኒድ ቱ ሳቲስፋይ አወር ከስተመርስ ኤንድ አወር ኤምፕሎይስ አዝ ዌል። ጥሩ ሰርቪስ መስጠት እንፈልጋለን፣ ጥሩ መስተንግዶ መስጠት እንፈልጋለን። ያንን ስናደርግ ደግሞ ምንድን ነው ለሀገራችንም ትልቅ ጥሩ ስም አገኘች ማለት ነው። እና በዋነኝነት እንዳልኩ የእንግዶቻችንን እርካታ መፍጠር ነው። ሰራተኞቻችንም በትሬኒንግም በተለያዩ ነገሮች
you talk is that about 160 rooms are your properties. I just wanted to know the occupancy rate.
Yes.
And besides, in addition to this Best Western class, there are two or three more hotels are coming up in the pipeline within the brand, but the same competition. And I just want to know your outlook on that. And maybe a few months later, Ethiopia is going to host the African Hotel Investment Forum.
Lila, entertainment which I'm going to talk about is a business lunch and an international dinner. I love it. I'm going to talk about music. ሙዚቃን በተመለከተ ከዛም የተነሳው ጥያቄ ሙዚቃ ቅዳሜ ቅዳሜ ላይ ያለን ቅዳሜ ቅዳሜ ማታ ላይ የተለያዩ ኢንተርናሽናልም ሀገራዊ ሙዚቃዎች በባንዶች ይቀርባሉ ማለት ነው። ስለዚህ ይሄም አንዱ ኢንተርቴንመንት ነው፣ ከህብረተሰቡ ጋር ያገናኛናል ብለን ያሰብነው ማለት ነው።
So occupancy, you want me to give you a figure?
You want me to give you a figure, yeah? Well, we're very happy to, as I said, okay, obviously you can put this figure. Obviously, depending the month, there are higher month and lower month. But, you know, occupancy, just to give you a bit of overlooking of, and this is also in line with the question from the lady about increasing or no increasing rate. Occupancy is a very, very, very basic KPI, okay, key indicator performance. I can have a lot of occupancy with a very low rate, so at the end of the day, you know, or I can have very low occupancy with a very high rate, and, you know, it goes to where it goes. As I have mentioned during my presentation, for us it's very, very important to deliver a good value for what you pay. So we are, our focus is not, and yeah, our focus and our strategy is not occupancy strategy. It's a well-balanced, give a good rate, deliver what we promise for this rate, so give a good value for what you pay. And we believe with this, slowly, once again, we just open hotel. In the next few years, this strategy will pay off, so we will have much more occupancy. As I have said also during my presentation, 12.6% is the official increase of demand in Addis, and only 4.3% the increase of supplier. So all the occupancy we have received is quite organic. You know, it comes naturally after 1 year opening. I have opened hotels that the first year is 20-30% occupancy. That's so we are very happy with this. And obviously, the occupancy depending on the volume, how much rooms you have. Because my 100% occupancy can be, or 100% occupancy of hotel of 50 or 60 rooms is my 50% occupancy. So overall, we're very happy with the occupancy we have achieved the first year. But once again, I want to say our focus is not on the occupancy, is to give a good value for the, what the our travelers are going to pay. Yes, there is one Best Western Plus in kind of on the pipeline. I have no idea. This is another investor, another hotel. And obviously, when a new hotel opens from the same brand, there is pluses or minuses. This hotel can get the benefit of all our PR and marketing activities and all our awareness as a brand. They can get the benefit, but we are 1 year older, so we have 1 year more experience. So as I said, the first year, first couple of years are very difficult. You are fine-tuning your property, your team, the guest expectations. So we strongly believe in our product, in our team, in what we are offering in the market, so we don't look around too much. We are much more focused in what we're confident in what we have and what we can offer to the market. Forum, which forum is it? Maybe you can. I don't know. Hotelier forum. When is that one?
If you're familiar with Reggio,
that's... We are, but I don't know about this one.
Anyway, African forum.
Is it Millennium or?
Economic Forum, maybe?
We are planning to host this ball in the Sheraton at the National Palace.
Uh-huh.
But it's the African-based annual forum. And previously, I think Addis has hosted twice this ball. It's just
Yeah, well, maybe not only this forum, but obviously any forum, any exhibition, any summit who comes to Addis and to any city in the world, maybe comparing with somebody was asking me about Barcelona, yeah? So that's one of the main difference. When the city brings big international or national forums to the capital, for us it's like, you know, we are full occupant. So the market demand, it goes immediately this week up. So that really helped us to reach our financial targets that our investors are expecting in order to, you know, pay back or get the return of investment as short as possible. So any forum is welcome to Addis, and more forums better for us and for everybody. But not only for hoteliers, for restaurants, for transportation, for shops, for everything. So every forum, once again, it's very much welcome for us. Answering yourself, visitors, what was the first question? How are you going to attract visitors to the hotel? It's not too specific enough. What type of visitors? You mean from abroad, internationally, or locally, internationally? Depending. If it's business visitors or if it's leisure visitors. We hold here last week the Ethiopian tour operators association annual meeting in this same room. So we have a very good relation with most of the main tour operators that they are dealing nationally and also international. We have identified some different feeding markets. As I said as well before, I believe very, very much strong because I go to Europe and I talk to friends and I talk to hoteliers that Ethiopia as a brand for leisure to come on holidays, it becomes stronger. You know, Dubai is strong, yeah, Barcelona is strong, Rome. I think Ethiopia slowly is becoming a very strong brand, such a brand. So we are reaching those markets through partners, tour operators and travel agencies, And we also try to adjust to their budgets. So we have some different packages for those. From the business point of view, we are signing plenty of, we have a very much dedicated sales team, which are constantly meeting the different different organizations and try to offer our services. On the other hand, here on my left, we have the PR and marketing manager, which we have a PR and marketing activities for awareness in the market. And we like, and one of our main focus, a part of the flyers, the radio, the traditional sources to make awareness, we are start working very much into the digital marketing, which I think is also one area of Ethiopia and Addis that it needs to be developed. Nowadays, the digital marketing is the new trend of market your hotel much more stronger and straight to the consumer. No, we don't have any plan to open any Ethiopian restaurant traditionally in our hotel. However, we are anything we do in terms of restaurants and bars, we always put the local Ethiopian food there, so we don't skip it. Let's give an example from yesterday. We have an Italian dinner in our restaurant, or we have the business lunch, or we always put the obviously the food that people demand, and if they demand, we are not going to take it away. Yes, this is a common thing when you have I cannot see the lady. Do you mind to move a bit? I would like to see. Yes, this is a market thing. When you have a big event in town, prices naturally they go up. Once again, our strategy, because we are 1 year old hotel, is increase our rates when we see that demand is high, but with certain sustainability. Okay, so we want to increase the rate when we can, but we want to be also realistic in the market and realistic with our product. So yes, they're always increasing during this time, but we like to do it in a certain with a certain sustainability and have at the end of the day a fair and a competitive rate in the market. I think that was the two questions or the two people.
Please move to visit.
Yeah, you move it. Okay.